Starch is one of the most important components of the human diet. It forms the main source of energy in our diet and is a key nutrient to humans. However, in recent years, starch consumption has been linked with a number of negative health outcomes, including obesity, diabetes, and cardiovascular disease. So my research is focused on understanding how we can process starch or where we can choose different sources of starch in order to improve our digestive health, and then understanding how those different structures passage through our digestive tract. An important theme in our research is selection of raw materials and working with plant breeders who are looking at natural variation in starch structure in crop plants. A couple of recent examples we've been working with is the wrinkled pea. So this is the mutation which was famously studied by Gregor Mendel. We've more recently discovered that it's a mutation in a starch branching enzyme, which gives rise to starch which is much more thermally resistant, is resistant to thermal processing, and therefore has much slower digestion properties. We also work with colleagues at NIAB in Cambridge who are exploiting natural variation in starch synthase genes, and they've developed this barley variety which has an altered starch synthase gene, and as a result both lower starch content and lower starch digestibility and increased dietary fibre. My research team is most interested in digestion of starches in the small intestine. When starch reaches the small intestine, it mixes with a complex combination of digestive fluids, which break down starch into simple sugars which we absorb. If that process happens too rapidly, then we get large increases in the amount of glucose we have in our bloodstream. And if this happens repeatedly over a long period of time, years or decades, then this can ultimately result in the development of type 2 diabetes. So we want to understand how we can process foods in order to slow this process down and in order to reduce the excursions in blood glucose. A further interest of my research group is colonic fermentation of starches. Sometimes when we eat starchy foods, if they're digested very slowly, a proportion of those starches will remain undigested and will pass into the colon, where they will act as dietary fibre. In the colon, they're broken down by a whole range of different bacteria which we have living in our guts in order to release beneficial healthy compounds which can help alleviate a number of diseases such as colonic cancer and type 2 diabetes. We want to understand how to maximise the delivery of starch to the colon, and also to understand how starch is broken down in the colon, which is currently not a well understood process. In order to achieve these aims, we're working with a number of partners outside of the Quadram Institute, including Imperial College London, King's College London, and KU Leuven in Belgium.